Hello and good morning to one and everybody. I, Purnima, welcome you to my class. I am a student. Today we are going to do part 2 of the 100 lessons. We have already completed part 1 and we are going to do part 2, the 100 lessons part 2 today. So already I have discussed writer in the 100 addresses. Of course, the same writer, L. Bessel Easter. Let me tell you something about her. Born in May 1906 and died. She was born on May 1906 and she died 15th July 1988. Was an American children's writer. Wrote many books, short stories, and she worked as a librarian for children's library. Her book Ginger Pyary won the New Fry Medal, and with that she became very famous. Aliyar based the story The 100 Dresses on her real life experience. As a girl who received Peggy's hand-me-down dresses. So I told her, I already discussed in my children chapter, in my lesson The 100 Dresses 1, that she was really, which girl she was in the story? Madeline. And we, in all the students used to call Maddie. So now children, I already told you, let me tell you some important point of the first part, then we can, we'll come to the second part. In the first part, it is based with the racial discrimination, and description is based on the basis of people used to do discrimination in the society on the basis of poverty. Alright, now here three major characters are here. One is Petra Petronovsky, she is a Polish immigrant. She came to USA, settled in USA, not liked by the people of USA for two reasons. First, she was a Polish immigrant. Second, she was a poor girl. So the rich used to make fun of poor girl. This is what the writer is throwing children focus on poverty. If people are poor, they are looked down upon as in the society. And here, the one thing is more added. The Americans never liked, they never accepted the immigrants from Poland. So these two are the things which is focused by the writer here. Now, the 100 dresses, part 1, the children, the main characteristic, Petra Petronovsky, she is a poor Polish immigrant. She lives in a boggy heights, that is a place where all the people live. And when she comes to the school, she is laughed and mocked by Peggy. Peggy is shown as a rich character without any financial problem in the story. Okay, and children, one more girl is there who is playing the role of a dumb character, and that is the writer herself. She is Madeline in the story. She could not say anything to Peggy, though she did not like, she never liked that Peggy is insulting her. Why? Because she is having her hand-me-down dresses. Though she did not like Peggy, that she is mocking Venta every time related with her dresses, her hats and footwear. But she could not say anything for two reasons again, children. First of all, she fear that she would be the next target of Peggy if she will tell her not to mock Venta Petronovsky. Secondly, the student, she herself was poor. She borrowed dresses from Peggy. She had this fear in her mind that Peggy would definitely insult her by telling her that she will be telling her what? She would be telling her that she is wearing her hand-me-down dresses. What is the meaning of hand-me-down dresses? Hand-me-down dresses here mean, children, the dresses when it becomes old, when we give to someone, that is known as hand-me-down dresses. So she keeps quiet. Now children, Venta was a quiet girl. She knew she did not see his heart. She did not like Peggy. But she is helpless. She could not say anything to her for two reasons. One, student, that she was knowing her status in the society, that poor immigrants from Poland are never like the Americans. Secondly, she is a poor girl, helpless girl. She had only one dresses, and she always used to wear only one dresses, that was a blue color faded dresses. She knew people always mocked at the poor people. This is society who makes fun of the poor people, and she is very poor and she always be mocked. So definitely she used to be quiet. She was used to sit at the back. Now children, it is a what to say, people think that backbenchers are those people who did not get good marks. But Peggy has proved that she was quite intelligent. She is quite creative when she has won the drawing contest in the school. Unfortunately, Peggy is not there. She was not attending the class. She did not know that she is the winner of the girls medal. She was not, nobody knew where she has left. Nobody knew why she is absent for so many days. So with that, chapter number one was children, it ended. Okay. Peggy is shocked because she always used to come, she always used to win the girls medal. She is shocked that this time Wanda has won the medal for the girls. And children, the teacher praised Wanda for her creativeness, for her intelligence, for drawing beautiful dresses. Even the boys, they whistled for her. Okay, so she has proved that though she is sitting at the back, she is not, though she is a backbencher, but she is not the girl who gets poor marks. She is quite intelligent and creative girl. Now children, we are coming to the 100 dresses part 2. This is our topic of our chapter of today. So first of all, I would like to read the theme of this story. Already first part we have done, so now we are going here for the second part. So children, what is the theme of the story? It becomes rather difficult for a poor immigrant like Wanda Petronowski to adjust herself in an environment which is not very conducive to her. So it was very difficult to adjust in the environment. Why it was too difficult for her to adjust in the environment? Because children, people used to mock her for two reasons. First of all, she is a Polish immigrant. Secondly, she was from a poor background. She was from the poor family. So Wanda Petronowski, it was very difficult to adjust because people keeps on mocking at her. They keep on insulting her. All the students love her. Nobody was her friend. She used to come to school alone. She used to go from the school alone. So rather, she was very disappointed with the children status of immigrants in the society. It becomes rather difficult for a poor immigrant like Wanda Petronowski to adjust herself in an environment which is not very conducive to her. However, Wanda rises above all these petty considerations. She still loves her previous school and her classmate. She is generous enough to donate her 100 drawing to her classmate. Now, though the society children behave rough with the poor people, even her classmates, they used to behave roughly with her. But children, she is generous enough to donate her 100 dresses to her classmate. She has no ill feeling towards Peggy, who used to tease her by putting embarrassing questioning regarding her dresses. She allowed Peggy to have the drawing of the green dress and Maddie the blue one. However, the damage has been done. In his letter to Miss Mason, Wanda's father clearly mentioned how he is forced to move out of the place and get his children admitted to a new school. So children, already the damage has been done, but his father has wrote a letter to the teacher that how they were forced to leave their country, okay, and how difficulty they got their children to get admitted to a new school. The message is very clear. Any kind of discrimination does torture those who suffer it silently. So what does the children hear in this chapter? What message the writer want to give us? The writer want to tell us that any type of torture, any type of misconduct, any type of bad behavior, any type of mocking or insulting children is really, children, it hurts the person who suffers. Children, they suffer silently, and one of the example is Wanda Petrowski herself. Okay, so with this children, so this was the main theme of the lesson. So student, now I'm going to tell you the background of the story. Okay, so first of all, I will be writing the important point and I will be explaining you the lesson. A letter from Wanda's father. Miss Mason received a note from the principal's office. She read it several times. She studied it thoughtfully. Then again she read the letter to the class. Wanda's father clearly made it clear that both his children, Wanda and Jack, could not come to their previous school anymore. They would not be insulted for having their funny names anymore in the new big city as they face it in their previous school. So children, Miss Wanda, the teacher, the class teacher got a letter from Wanda's father. He had straight away told in the letter that their son Jack and their his daughter Wanda, she is being insulted in the school just because of three things. They are poor. They are from the children. They are the Polish immigrant, and they are having funny name. So that was the reason that they are taking out their children. He is taking out their children from the school. Deep silence in the class. When the class heard this, there was a deep silence in the class. My second point is deep silence in the class. A deep silence prevailed in the whole class. The letter had an immediate effect. A deep silence prevailed in the room. Miss Mason spoke in a low voice. She wished that none of the boys and girls in room 13 would purposely and deliberately hurt anybody for having a long and unfamiliar name. What was said was said in a thoughtfulness. It was a very unfortunate and sad thing that Wanda had to face such a situation. So the children, class teacher was shocked that she had to face such a situation. She was shocked. She told that it is unfortunate that our class, which is there in room number 13, is facing such a situation, that a girl who was being insulted every day should not have happened. Will not happen from now in room number 13. A deep silence prevailed in the whole room. Miss Mason spoke in a low voice. She wished that none of the boys and girls in the room 13 would deliberately and purposely insult anybody for having a long and unfair name. She told this thing in such a thoughtfulness and serious manner that all the students had an effect on when she told this thing to her class. Maddie had sick feeling. Children, when this was told by the class teacher, our third important point is Maddie had sick feeling. Maddie had a sick feeling. Maddie was highly disturbed. She could not put her mind on her lesson. She was not able to concentrate. She was thinking that she is also had an important role to insult Wanda, and that's why she was greatly hurt and she had to leave the school. She could not concentrate on her lesson. That day she had a very sick feeling in the bottom of her stomach. She cursed herself for remaining silent when Peggy teased Venda Petronovsky for her dresses, for her shoes, for her hat. She only stood by silently and said nothing. It was as bad as what Peggy had done. So she was thinking that she is equally to part in insulting Venda Petronovsky, though she was a very good girl. She did not say anything to her. When she was nothing less than a coward. So she started cursing herself as coward person. She put herself in Venda's shoes. She decided to find Venda. It was possible that she had no left bargain hide yet. So still she was wishing she should go to Venda, and she wished that she should not left her place bargain hide yet. Peggy had also the same idea. Both the girls planned to visit Venda's house at Bogin Heights. So children, both the girls, they felt sorry. They felt that they are responsible for her leaving the school. And for the first time, Peggy also realizes that she was the person who had really hurt Venda Petronovsky. Peggy and Maddie visited Venda's house. Now children, fourth point is, it was Peggy and Maddie who visited Venda's house. So children, the two girls set out for Boggins Heights, the place where Venda Petronovsky used to live. Peggy felt that she never called Venda a foreigner and made fun of her name. She thought that Venda was too dumb. She praised her drawing skill. Okay, so she praised her drawing skill. At last they reached Venda's house. It was a little house with a shabby but clean courtyard. They knocked firmly on the door but got no answer from there. The Petronovsky had left the place. It was very sad. Peggy said that if she had not asked Venda about all her dresses, she would have no idea for her drawing. She might not have won the contest either. Okay, so children, it was Peggy who was thinking that she has left because of her, but at the same time she was feeling if she would not have made fun of her, she would not be the winner of the girls team, because she would not have drawn the dresses, the 100 dresses. So she was responsible for Venda's leaving the house as well as Venda win due to Peggy children, because she got so hurt. Okay, so now Maddie resolves. Now our fifth point is, so children, Maddie resolved. Okay, so Maddie thought she is equally responsible for Venda's dresses, because she could not resist. She could not open her mouth to Peggy. So she was feeling very guilty conscious. She was feeling that she is the girl who is also responsible for Venda's leaving the place. So when Maddie thought about Venda, okay, now children, Maddie was thinking, she was remembering Venda with the blue fitted dresses and a little house she had lived in. She reached an important conclusion. Children, suddenly Maddie made an important conclusion of her life. She was not going to stand by and say nothing again. Now children, she was so feeling sad. She was thinking she was equally responsible for Venda, okay, to, and as she has to leave the place. So she tells that from now she would never forgive anyone who is insulting other in the class. She will never keep quiet if anyone insult anyone in the class. Okay, and she would never forgive anyone insulting others because they were funny looking or had strange names or they are poor or they are immigrant. She would stand up and speak up for those who are insulting her. She would oppose injustice even if it means losing Peggy friendship. So children, she decided this thing and she really felt satisfied. Now my next point is, Peggy and Maddie wrote a letter to Brenda. Okay, so Peggy and Maddie, children, Peggy still was thinking she was not responsible. 100% she is not responsible as Brenda is leaving the place. But at the same time, she is thinking that she is the one with the help of whom she got the prize also. She is the winner of the contest. So, but children, in their heart, they were suffering. They were having this feeling that they are responsible for Brenda's patronosity leaving the place. So, finally, they decided to write a letter. Peggy and Maddie wrote a letter to Brenda. Okay, Peggy and Maddie decided to write a letter to Brenda. They wrote how pretty her drawings were. They asked her if she liked her new place and her new teacher. They wanted to feel sorry, but they ended up with writing just a friendly letter. Now children, again children, Peggy had a yugyo because she did not ask sorry in that letter, not even Maddie. Okay, they only wanted to convey that they really felt sorry, but they did not express. They simply wrote just a friendly letter. Now children, letter from Brenda Petronovsky, a very important point. So our seventh point is letter from Brenda Petro. Well, children, on the last day of school before Christmas holiday, Miss Messel received a letter. It was from Brenda Petronovsky. She wished that the girls of room 13 could keep those 100 dresses. She had a new, she had a few 100 dresses in her new house. She would like Peggy to have the drawing of the green dress and Maddie to have the blue one. She wrote that she missed the school. Her new teacher did not equalize Miss Messel. So now children, Peggy had written one letter. Okay, so what was that letter? On the last day of school before Christmas holiday, Miss Messel received a letter from Brenda. It was from Brenda Petronovsky. Madam was impressed. She was happy that the child still remember and respect her. She wished that the girls of room 13 could keep those 100 dresses. So in that she has written that girls, if they want to keep those drawings of 100 dresses, they can keep, they can use them. She had a few new 100 dresses in her new house. She would like Peggy to have the drawing of the green dress and Maddie to have the blue one. She wrote that she missed the school. Her new teacher did not equalize Miss Messel. So she also told that her new teacher was not like Miss Messel. She really admired Miss Messel because she was really a very good teacher. Well, last she wrote,
Brenda, liked Peggy and Maddie.
Okay. Peggy told Maddie that Brenda actually liked them. She replied their letter. There was no ill feeling among them. Now, children, maybe just to satisfy it, or maybe Brenda is a girl who did not want to hurt anybody. There was no ill feeling, children, among them. Peggy told that she had replied to her, and she is told that she actually liked them. Everything was all right. Maddie felt sad that they would never see little Polish girl again. She went home. She pinned the drawing on the wallpaper. Tears blurred her eyes. For the Pfaff children, she felt so sad. She felt that she is also responsible for Brenda leaving, and how nicely Brenda had forgiven them by telling just few words that she still liked them. Tears came into her eyes. Tears blurred into her eyes. She looked intently and found that the face and head of the drawing looked like her. Excitedly, she ran over to Peggy. She showed Peggy her picture. The head and face of her picture also did look like Peggy. Peggy replied that Brenda must have really liked them. Okay, so children, this is all. So you can see how great was Brenda Petronowski. She did not told anybody that how insulted she was in the school, that finally she had to leave the school. Okay, the teacher Miss Messon got, now once again children, let me focus on the important point. The teacher Miss Messon got a letter from Brenda Petronowski father. She read Brenda's father letter to the class. He informed that his children Brenda and Jack would never come to their school again because they are greatly hurt. He told how bad the people feel, how great they suffer if anybody mock them, if anybody insult them due to their funny names or due to their poverty or due to their Polish emigrancy. Miss Messer spoke in a sad low voice to the class, and she perhaps what was said was very sad and unfortunate. True, Maddie did not like Peggy putting embarrassing question to Brenda Petronowski. And children, the teacher also told that from nobody in room number 13 is going to hurt anybody now. She wanted to tell Brenda that her 100 dresses were beautiful. Maddie felt guilty as she stood silently and never opposed Peggy when she was teasing Brenda. Both the girls, Patty and Brenda, set out to Boggenheide, where Brenda used to live. The place when they went was, their house was empty. They have left the place. Brenda and the family, they left the place. They knocked the door loudly but got no answer. It was clear that Brenda Petronowski and her family had gone, sadly, from there also. Peggy told Maddie that when she was asking Brenda about her dresses, Brenda probably was getting good ideas for her drawing. Maddie made an important decision. Both Peggy and Maddie decided to write a letter to Brenda Petronowski. They asked Brenda if she liked her new places and the new teacher. They also wrote that their drawings were very beautiful and she wants the girls' medal. They also wanted to feel sorry, but they ended up writing a friendly letter on the last day of school before the holiday. Miss Messon informed the class that she received a letter from Brenda Petronowski. In the letter, Brenda wished that the girls of room number 13 could keep those beautiful drawing of her 100 dresses. She wished that the drawing of the green dress should be given to Peggy as she liked the design so much, and the blue one to Maddie. Maddie went home and watched the drawing intently. Peggy could only say to Maddie, she must have really liked us. So children, with this children, chapter is end. I finished my this background and the main important point. Tomorrow's lesson, children, we will be finishing. We will be starting this new lesson, and with this children, okay, I will take the leave. But children, here, three important characters are here. One is Miss Messon character. She is very mature and understanding human being. She had given a quite a nice lesson to her class by telling that from now nobody will hurt, nobody will insult any student. Okay, and she also told about Wanda Patnorsky's letter to the class that they are in a big city, but her teacher is not like Miss Messon. Miss Messon is a full of human kindness. Okay, here children, Madeline had decided she would not hurt anyone and she would not keep quiet if anybody insult anyone from now. So with this, I take a leave. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.